Hi and welcome to carperformance.se. I'm gonna show you our latest sync-free V4 Android system. The V4 is totally new hardware, much faster system, more RAM, later Android system. We also integrated the Android sound to the car speaker without Bluetooth. So we're gonna do a short demonstration here. Here we have the factory system, and to switch, it will depend on what car you have, but in some car you can switch with the steering wheel, this arrow here, and some cars will also have this arrow here to switch with. You press that for 3 seconds, or this one. And some cars will have the voice key for switching. Just press that for 3 seconds. And some also will have the sound. So it all depends on what car. For this car, we switch with this steering wheel button. I know for F150, 250 and 350, you will have the voice key to switch with. You press that and hold that for 3 seconds. It all depends on what car, but the voice key will always work in each car. So we're gonna do a switch here. So
golden.
We have the radio sound here. Gonna switch here. Gonna go back to the how the system looks when you get it. So when you switch, you see you can have the radio sound in the background and still be in the Android system. We're gonna show you also how to have the Android sound in the car's full system. Settings. We're gonna do a setup video, also go through all the settings and all the apps in another video to show you. If you want to have internet to use, like for YouTube, you need of course to connect our Android system to a hotspot. Either you share your phone as a hotspot and connect it to that, or you can buy our mobile hotspot. Just plugs into the USB port of the car, and in here you just insert a SIM card with a data plan. This works worldwide. So as soon as you start up the car, the Android system will automatically connect to the hotspot, and you will have internet. Then you don't need to turn on and off your phone's hotspot. You can download of course all the apps that you want. You got the Play Store. You need a Google account of course, but that's free. Then you can search for, let's say, Waze. We already installed on this, so you can install any apps that you want. And we got we got one extra camera input for DTV. We don't have a camera connected now, so it would say no signal, but if your car has reverse camera, it will show in the Android system also. So when you go to reverse and then you go to drive, it will show the front camera. So it's really good for parking. It can be viewed at all speed at any time. And to exit it, just slide down, and you will get this bar. So you press the home key. We will switch back now to let the Android sound in the car's speak system. The only thing that you need to do is just take a normal thumb drive, put one MP3 song on it, one music file, it doesn't matter which one. Insert it into the USB port of the car, go to sources, and then you will get the USB unit 1. Press that, and that's for Android sound. Now when I'm switch, I will go to YouTube. can take Lady Gaga. So now you will have the sound in the car's full speaker system. This is for accessing these apps, but we recommend that when you install the system, we recommend that you install Car Launcher Pro from Google Play Store and run that as your launcher. It looks much nicer, it works perfect with our system. I'm gonna show you later how it looks like. You can also, of course, we like to have the tuning radio running. There was the tuning radio. You can add the tuning radio and have the Google Maps at the same time. Then when you get the voice direction, the tuning radio will mute, and the Google Voice, you will hear that. It can be like this. And we go to maps. So it will mute the tuning radio and speak. We are always only in the Android system at all times. So all apps that you want, you can have Netflix and view that. And of course you can also, we're going to show, when you are in the Android system and you get a phone call to your phone that's connected to the factory system by hands-free, the screen will change to that. I'll show you here. So if you get a call, the screen will go back to the factory system to show who is calling. So, and when you end that call, it will automatically switch back to the Android system. Also, if you're making voice directions, or if you want to use the voice key, it will go to the factory system. So if I press it once here, hitta en adress.
Gjort, följt av gata och gatunummer.
Avbryt. So that will also go back to the factory, so it's totally integrated with the Sync 3, and it will work in all Sync 3 cars worldwide. Just make sure that you have updated your Sync 3 to the 3.0 software. There you have the 3.0. If you don't have updated, go to your Ford.com and enter your VIN number and download the latest update. And if your car has factory navigation, if you set the destination there and then switch to the Android system, and you're watching Netflix, let's say, then when you get a direction, it will mute the Netflix or whatever you're watching and say the direction. So it's perfect to use. So we're gonna start selling this week, so we'll have it on our website. And like we said, all depends, the switch function all depends on which car you have. Either it's the right steering wheel key, or the right on the other side, or the voice key, or the sound key, and all is by pressing them for 3 seconds. We also recommend, if you have an iPhone and the only way in your car is to switch by voice key, we recommend that you turn off the Siri function, because if you press the voice key for 3 seconds, it will turn on Siri also. So like you see here, now we have an iPhone connector, but we have disconnected the Siri. So if you press and hold 3 seconds, it will switch without getting in this. So please check us out and subscribe to our channel. We're gonna also do a setup video and also a installation video for this new Android V4 system. Much faster, more RAM, later Android system, more internal memory, plug and play, sound through the factory system, through the USB, so you can have your phone connected, one extra video input for camera. It's everything that you need. It also got 2 USB inputs, so you can watch video, or now we don't have anything connected, or if you want to listen to music. So thank you very much.